You're watching the Second News Hour debate on Times Now Super Prime Time.
So Rahul Gandhi gives a long lecture on corruption, and many people say that his doublespeak on corruption has been exposed by the fact that he's silent on the critical issue of the Aadharsh scam, in which somebody he supports, Ashok Chauhan, is indicted and he refuses to take any action against him. Shakti Singh Goyal joins the debate, Congress leader and spokesperson. Taking him on is Smriti Irani. Sunil Alagh, who is, how do I describe, he's a Modi-leaning, part of the Modi camp.
Not part of the, I like Modi.
You like Modi. And
I like Modi
at an independent
much.
Level.
Absolutely at an independent level.
Well, and also with us today is Kumar Ketkar, chief editor of Daily Divya Marathi of the Bhaskar Group. Kumar Ketkar, to start with you first, do you think Rahul Gandhi, you know, he gives one lecture on corruption before Fiki, but when it comes to Ashok Chauhan, he does nothing?
Well, actually, I don't think it should be described as double speak. I think he expressed his real concern. I don't want to defend him, because the question is not exactly whether he controlled corruption or not, but the simple question is whether he talked sincerely or not. I think he was sincere. That doesn't mean immediately sincere actions will follow, because even Narendra Modi is considered as a very sincere and a great profound man, but he is ready to take Yediyurappa in, and he is also not able to control corruption in Gujarat. So I think let us take people at least at their sincerity value, not necessarily that action value. Between sincerity and action,
this is a remarkable argument, Kumar Ketkar. It's a remarkable argument.
Rahul Gandhi,
Sunil Alagh is smiling out here. So your argument basically is this, that you should never be sincere in both thoughts and action. If you are sincere in thoughts but insincere in actions,
You have to be sincere in thought. You have to be sincere in thought, but to be sincere in action is difficult even for all the people who claim to be honest from Jayaprakash Narayan and perhaps even earlier leaders.
This is a fairly desperate attempt to defend Rahul Gandhi. Smriti Irani.
Smriti Irani.
This is a new theory. Rahul Gandhi is a sincere person. He's sincere in his thoughts. And Kumar Ketkar says that even Narendra Modi is insincere in his actions. So Rahul Gandhi shouldn't be focused on too much.
Well, Kumar Ketkar begins this debate with a very stupendous performance, says that he doesn't want to defend Rahul Gandhi but ends up defending him, mind reads Narendra Modi and goes on to make many presumptions on your debate tonight. That Rahul Gandhi has indulged in double speak on various issues
I'm
has
not
been
defending
exposed
anybody.
On Times Now time and again. Mr. Ketkar, allow me to finish. That Mr. Rahul Gandhi has indulged in double speak on various issues has been exposed time and again on Times Now, vis-a-vis corruption, yes. Mr. Rahul Gandhi speaks in the Lok Sabha, vents his heart out at Fiki and talks about how corruption needs to be curbed, but is extremely silent when the Aadharsh report is rejected by the Maharashtra government. Mr. Rahul Gandhi speaks about the need to have a very strong Lokpal, but doesn't speak on the night of 29 December 2011 when Rajya Sabha proceedings are abruptly halted. Mr. Rahul Gandhi speaks about the rights of farmers, but speaks nothing when the Maharashtra-led government shoots at farmers at Mawal, which was telecasted on Times Now. That's why I'm saying that Rahul Gandhi's double speak on various issues, including corruption, has been exposed time and again.
Rahul Gandhi says, Shakti Singh Goyal, Smriti has a point. Rahul Gandhi says before Fiki, corruption is bleeding our nation dry. It is an unacceptable burden on the people of our nation. We must fight corruption with all our strength and determination. Now, if you look at what has happened in the case of Ashok Chauhan, Rahul Gandhi should say this. We must fight corruption with all our strength and determination as long as it does not involve Congress people. We must fight corruption with all our strength and determination as long as it does not involve former chief ministers of the Congress like Ashok Chauhan. And we must fight corruption with all our strength and determination as long as it does not affect the Congress party fortunes. We can criticize everybody on corruption. So Rahul Gandhi's manifesto obviously means that you should fight corruption among everyone else except the Congress party.
Let me tell you two things. Kathni aur karni ek honi chahiye. I'll give you just two examples.
Ne, Rahul Gandhi like ki kathni aur karni ek honi chahiye ki nahi? Chauhan, ne, what about Rahul Gandhi's kathni aur karni?
Let me finish, please, my dear. Let me have at least 30 minutes.
So, Smriti
without
was,
any
no,
interruption, let me finish
no, I
just
want to
30
ask
minutes.
You,
please, I
want to ask you just one
rather
question.
Rather than tutu meme.
Ek sawal hai.
Please, I have heard your question. Now, at least give me some opportunity.
Sir, please, you understand that Rahul Gandhi is in the dock tonight and you are representing Rahul Gandhi. When you are saying Kathni, what is it? Kathni or Karni?
Yes, and
which means thought and deed.
I am requesting you.
No, no. So,
have some patience to hear.
No. Are you talking
have
about Rahul Gandhi?
To hear my point.
Please. Are you talking about Rahul Gandhi?
Yes. And that's why I'm telling you, have some patience. Please have some patience.
So you are saying Rahul Gandhi's thoughts and deeds don't
what
match.
What I'm telling is that. May I say now?
Okay, you can explain. But Smriti, after you complete.
May I go ahead?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
I'm telling you that in Congress party, whenever there was an allegation, like there was an allegation against Ashok Chauhan, as a chief minister, Ashok Chauhan had resigned. Here in Gujarat, Modi is speaking against corruption,
sir, what is this
but
argument?
A convicted criminal. Oh, convicted. Oh, yeah, you will have to note this. He is a minister and continued minister. Another minister against whom the
just
High Court has certified the corruption of 420 crores.
No, one sec. Sir, that's not a satisfactory answer.
Yes,
I can
and Rahul
see,
Gandhi.
No, sir, please understand one thing. It's a very simple question.
I am coming to the point. If you are not allowing me to speak for 30 seconds, this is not fair. Then there is no point
Goyal,
in taking
I think you're avoiding the
debate.
Subject.
Smriti ji can go ahead as long as she wish.
No, she wants to counter you. She wants
you are not allowing me to finish my point.
She wants to counter you. She feels you're not understanding. Maybe you're not, you know, you've... See, Mr. Goyal, just answer one question. Should Rahul Gandhi
I am telling
act
you
against
that
Ashok Chauhan or not?
Rahul Gandhi as a general secretary. Rahul Gandhi as a general secretary. When he was in charge of a youth and NSUI, that was he who made compulsory that no youth leader against whom just
sir,
a
please,
criminal
I'm asking you about Adarsh Kargil for
election.
Profit,
and
a
he
former chief minister
and he didn't
who has
allow
been indicted.
Any criminal.
Sir, a chief, former chief minister who's been caught as part of a quid pro quo nexus of benefits derived by his close relatives. Why is Rahul Gandhi scared to act against Ashok Chauhan? One second, Smriti, before I come to you, Sunil Alag is countering you as well. Sunil Alag, one second. 1 minute, Sunil.
You don't want to reply to this question.
Sir, you listen to the other side.
Will you
side,
please
sir?
Allow me to reply to your question?
Sir, please. Sunil Alag yeah. wants to say something to you.
You know, I was at the FICCI meeting.
I have the Go copy ahead. Of the report.
Okay, fine. I was at the FICCI meeting when Rahul Gandhi spoke to us. And let me tell you, for the first 10 minutes, I was very impressed. And I'm being open about it. And I really brought whatever Ketkar is saying about him being sincere. Then after 10 minutes, I said, he is the ruling party. What does he want to change? He's speaking like the opposition leader that this is what I have to change, not only in the nation, but within my party. And as far as I'm concerned, there are two things that come out of what Rahul is saying. And if we give him the benefit of the doubt that he's sincere and he's a person, then it's a question of saying that nobody in the party listens to him. So either he's powerless and therefore he's sincere. Or if he's got the power and he's saying something, nobody in the party is following him.
What is being said here? One sec, Smriti also wants to say something to you. Sir, please remember this, that this is a very serious report. It's the Adarsh report. It names three other former Congress chief ministers also in the past. Sushil Kumar Shinde, late Vilas Rao Chauhan, and Shivaji Rao Patil Nilangekar for extending political patronage to Adarsh.
Sir, please. Vilas Rao Deshmukh.
Huh?
Vilas Rao Deshmukh
and Shivaji Rao Patil. So we are Mr. Goyal, don't be touchy. What is Rahul Gandhi's position on these people? That's all that we are asking.
And
that's all. You have no answer to that.
Yes,
very
and
quick.
I'm coming to that. If you
are
allowing me,
by
if
the
you will allow me, I'll,
I'm
coming
leader.
To that.
So now their own judicial committee, their own report, without giving any reason, they trash it. I mean, it's not an external, it's been appointed by the Chief Minister of Maharashtra. And the cabinet trashes it without giving any reason whatsoever.
Smriti Irani also wants to say something to you. And after that, I'm going to give you a full opportunity to rebut. Mr. Goyal, remember, you're in the dock today. Smriti.
Well, one of the beneficiaries that you named in your debate, Arnab, Sushil Kumar Shinde, who is now the Home Minister of India, had very famously once said, when asked whether corruption will be a big challenge for the Congress party in elections, very famously said, "Log bhool jayenge." And I think that is what Mr. Goyal expects this evening on your debate, that people have forgotten the double speak of the Congress party and especially Mr. Rahul Gandhi. He says that Ashok Chauhan resigned. Well, there is a press meet of Mrs. Sonia Gandhi where she very openly declared that Ashok Chauhan was sacked for indulging in corruption vis-a-vis the Adarsh scam. Now, when it comes to Mr. Gohil's attack on the BJP with regards to a so-called convicted criminal. Let me enlighten him very humbly that after the Supreme Court judgment vis-a-vis the Lily Thomas case, no convicted MLA or MP can retain their position if they are convicted of any wrongdoing. Hence, for Mr. Gohil to indulge in malicious gossip on your channel tonight is expected and extremely, I think, unfortunate, because the question tonight which is being posed to him, though uncomfortable, is this, that if Mr. Rahul Gandhi is extremely keen of ridding India of corruption, why then is he not impressing upon the Chief Minister of Maharashtra,
so what is the compulsion,
to act upon the inquiry committee findings with regards
what
to
is,
the others?
I want now at this stage, Mr. Gohil, to be honest with the viewers, to share the facts with the viewers and to confess, if required, to the viewers about what really is the problem why Rahul Gandhi can't act against Ashok Chauhan. Mr. Gohil, in today's politics, in today's age, people appreciate honesty.
First, let me tell you that I have the copy of the judgment.
Which judgment are you holding?
I have a copy of the judgment. A convicted criminal on 15 June 2013. Oh. Smriti ji, 15 June 2013, he was convicted.
Right.
No stay was
Mr.
granted
Gohil.
For days together, and he
Mr.
continued
Gohil,
as a so
BJP is doing
the
something wrong.
I didn't interrupt you. Have a patience to listen.
Why don't you answer questions directly regarding Rahul Gandhi?
You get your turn. I didn't interrupt you.
Why don't you?
No, I'm asking the question, Mr. Gohil. Mr. Gohil, I'll ask questions to the BJP. I'll show you.
Is this a way?
No, Mr. Gohil, 1 minute. I'll ask questions to the BJP. Yeah. I will ask questions, but 1 minute. The fact is, we are now asking questions of your party Vice President Rahul Gandhi. He never fails to mention, whenever he gets a chance, you know, Rahul Gandhi's favorite line is, we brought the Right to Information Act. Why don't you ask Rahul Gandhi to tell us, this Adarsh report, there was a Right to Information application by former Chief Information Commissioner Shailesh Gandhi. It did not see the light of day till it was tabled in the Assembly this month. Despite a Right to Information request to access the report, Shailesh Gandhi was not able to do so. He was asked to inquire in two other departments. He was kicked around here and there. That means there was a deliberate attempt by the Congress government to not disclose the contents of the Adarsh report. Now, on top of it, Rahul Gandhi's silence on this whole issue, the governor being told, refuse permission to prosecute Ashok Chauhan, lack of cooperation from the government in ensuring transparency. I'm asking you tonight, and I will ask the questions to the BJP. What are you hiding? What is Rahul Gandhi scared of? What are you hiding, sir? And why does Rahul Gandhi not realize that everybody will say that the whole crusade against corruption will be a joke? A joke, sir. If you refuse to give permission to prosecute Ashok Chauhan.